If Sam were here, I know that he would have something that he would want all of us to know and to believe. And for an opportunity to hear that message, we're going to hear from one of his near and dear friends, Zach Darlington. And he's going to share just briefly about that same message that Sam put his hope in. So, Zach Darlington.
When I got the news this morning, I think I was probably like a lot of people where I was just kind of numb. That kind of thing doesn't happen to Foles. Because everyone knows Foles and there's something different about him. He just had a presence about him. There's going to be a hole on our team now and it's not going to be filled because people like Foles don't come around often. He's probably the hardest worker that I've ever been around. But most of all, he was probably one of the greatest guys I've ever been around. I think that everyone can attest to that. Talking to one of my buddies, Luke Gifford, this morning. And I found out and I was very bitter and I was very angry because I knew how much of an impact not only did he have on my life, but that he had on everyone in Nebraska. Because Foles was the absolute best representative of what being a Husker football player could ever be about. And I know that it hit me because Friday, I sat in his locker with him after the workout. We clowned around and joked around and talked, and he said he was going to a camp, and I just assumed I'd see him Monday. I just keep realizing I'm not going to see him again, and it's killing me. But then when I talked to Robbie, he reassured me one thing was that I will see him again. Because Foles cared about his faith dearly, and he loved Jesus Christ with his whole heart. So one day I will see him in heaven. So I was willing to share today that if Foles were here, he would want you guys to realize that in the blink of an eye, it can all change. We've all seen that, and we all realize that, because no one expected this to happen. I think he'd want us to live every day like it was our last, because I know that that's how he approached every workout, every drill, every meeting, every interaction with anyone that he was ever with. It just constantly doesn't feel real. So if you guys would let me, I'd like to take a moment just to pray and just talk to God for you guys. Bow your heads, please. Lord Jesus, everyone's hurting right now. Their hearts are broken. Their lives are shattered. But there's no greater rock than you. And I know that right now, Foles is looking down. Because I know that the relationship that he had with you, and I there's not a shadow of a doubt in my heart that he's up there right next to you right now. I think that everyone is sad and just broken because we weren't ready to give him up. He was such a great person. Lord, I just pray that you'll be with his family. I can't imagine the loss that they're taking. If I thought he was a great guy in my life, I can't imagine having a son like that. A true gentleman and a representative of Christ. I pray that you be with his friends and the team here and the people in the community and the lives that he impacted. I pray that you just constantly be a reminder that we do have another chance to see him. I pray that everyone will live their life like that. I pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.